in May 2017. I got called to model in a photo shoot that was labeled the Decade Shoot. Upon arriving to the shoot, the designer named Jon Pierce walked me over to model Deborah Hahn and photographer Scott Thomason. At the time, Deborah Hahn was posing with a red hat by an England-themed phone booth. And that sparked my next film. It never occurred to me to make a film that was in a different decade, but after being there at that shoot and seeing just how styles have changed and how classic the 50s is, it made it just seem 100% right that that was the way to go for my next project. So I began writing the film. It had the working title Time Change, and after about a month and a half of that, I called in Gilbert, Laberge, who I previously worked with on Violators. I called him in to help flesh out the script a little more, as I was unsatisfied with the drafts I was putting together. He came on board, and after several months of screenwriting, going over various concepts and several different scripts, we came up with Decades Apart. At this moment in time, I didn't feel like producing another film like I did my last two. I produced Under the Gun and Violators myself, and I didn't feel like it would be the greatest decision for me to do that again creatively, as my focus would be stretched in several different places, and that was something I didn't feel would be the right move for Decades Apart. Thus led me to involve False Park Entertainment. After a couple months of casting, we brought on board Deborah Hahn as Diane Flint Watson, and Martin Tylicki as Nathan Grimm. This was the best casting I could have asked for this film. The main reason I'm so proud of this film is not because it's my newest film, it's because it has an iconic edge to it that my past films have failed to have. The wardrobe, I feel anyways, is on point. Thank you, Mr. Jon Pierce, for that one. The lighting by Angelo to Pardo is stellar. The cinematography by Charlotte Acker is classic. The sound is crystal clear by Collins White. Is the music, which was supplied to us by the two cellos. They had a fantastic cover of Hurt from Johnny Cash. That's probably one of my favorite songs of all time, and it's featured in this film, and it goes perfectly with the whole tone, especially of Diana's character arc. But the most important element of this film of all is the originality of the story. Gilbert, Laberge and I came up with a story that I feel has not been done before. And that's a hard thing to do in a world where almost everything has been done. The closest similarity is The Lake House, a movie with Keanu Reeves, where they're sending letters to a mailbox. This is different. The story here is an anomaly in space-time sends a call from 1953 to 2018 to an unexpected Nathan Grimm. And he receives the call, and a timeless connection is formed. I'm not going to spoil the plot, because if I do, there's no reason for you to watch it. The film is now available on Amazon.com and Amazon.co.uk, and it's available in 60 countries across the world, so there's many different ways you can watch it, depending on where you're located. But so far, the film is getting great reviews, and I look forward to hearing more of your thoughts, and I hope you all go and check out the film.